Okay, good morning, Vanda. Let's try to recall what we have done till now. This expression corresponds to DTFT, discrete time Fourier transform. This is also known as analysis equation, DTFT, or known as analysis equation. X of e power j omega equal to sigma n equals minus infinity plus infinity x of n e power minus j omega n. This is analysis equation or DTFT of x of n. And this is known as synthesis equation or inverse discrete time Fourier transform. Inverse discrete time Fourier transform of x of e power j omega. 1 by 2 pi integral minus pi to pi x of e power j omega into e power j omega n d omega. This is also known as Y synthesis equation, means we are trying to synthesize this sequence x of n with the help of complex exponential sequences e power j omega. This is some weighted combination of complex exponential sequences, right? Integration is nothing but a continuous summation. It's a weighted summation of complex exponential sequence with the help of complex exponential sequences. That's why we are calling it a synthesis equation. This is analysis equation. The reason for this one is we are trying to see what are the frequency components in this sequence x of n. That's why this is called as analysis equation. Okay, can someone answer what are the convergence conditions for DTFT to exist for the given sequence x of n? For uniform convergence, what should be the condition for uniform convergence? That should be absolutely summable, right? Absolutely. The sequence should be absolutely summable. Then you can try to say that will converge uniformly, the DTFT for x of n. This sequence x of n should be absolutely summable. It should be finite. It means less than infinite. For mean square convergence, there should be square summable. The sequence should be square summable. Mod x of n. For this need not be satisfied. This absolute summability. One of the example for this one is ideal low pass filter we have seen, right? One example that we saw is h of n equals to sine omega cn by pi n. This corresponds to ideal low pass filter impulse response with a cutoff frequency omega c. This is not absolutely summable, but this is a square summable sequence. There we have seen mean square convergence. When coming to ideal low pass filter, this is minus omega c, this is omega c, this is h of e power j omega, so 1, say pi, and minus pi. You can show only minus pi to pi, right? By default, this is periodic. So repeat for every 2 pi, that h of e power j omega, or the DTFT, by default. There is some issue at this sharp transition, right? Some ripple kind of thing you might expect at this point. Still, that will converge in the mean square sense. In the uniform convergence, may not be possible when that is not absolutely summable. But if that's not absolutely summable and somehow that's mean square summable, then this will work out. Still, you can find DTFT, but that will converge in the mean square sense. At these edges, you will find some issue, right? Small issue. This is okay. There is no issue with this one. It's between part. When there is a discontinuity, there is some issue. That's it. And one more thing, there are some sequences which are not absolutely summable. And not square summable. They are not square summable also. Can you give me any example for this? We already saw this. X of n equals to some constant. For example, x of n equal to 1 for all n. For all n equals to minus infinity plus infinity, x of n equals to 1. This is not absolutely summable. is not square summable also, because sigma 1 square is sigma 1. See, for example, n equals minus infinity plus infinity, x of n means 1 for all n. It equals infinity, right? And sigma n equals to minus infinity plus infinity, 1 square, this is also infinite, right? 1 square is 1. We are adding 1 infinite times. This is not square summable, this is not absolutely summable. Still, you can find Fourier transform, right? Then what is the DTFT for 1? We already saw, right? Yeah, what is DTFT for constant or DC? 2 pi, can you speak? Yeah. Yes, 2 pi delta. Is it DC, right? Omega plus 2 pi k or 2 pi r, whatever you want. This is periodic with period 2 pi, right? With the help of special functions, analog impulse function, with the help of to resolve this issue, right? Even though that's not absolutely summable and that's not square summable, still I can find DTFT with the help of special function called as analog impulses, right? With the help of this, you can try. And what about this? What is the DTFT for this? E by omega naught n? Delta of omega minus omega naught plus 2 pi k. This is a DTFT for E by omega naught n. This is also not absolutely summable. This is also not square summable. Still, I can find DTFT with the help of special functions known as analog impulses. Okay, let me go to these ones. Okay, this table is from discrete time signal passing by Oppenheim. It's a reference. Okay, let me go to symmetry properties of Fourier transform. Okay, before going to that one, let us try to discuss what are even signals and odd signals. Can someone answer what is the condition for even signal? Even signal, x of minus n should be equals to
x of n, sir.
Yes, x of minus n should be equals to x of n for all n. Then you can call it as even signal. And odd signal, or you can say even symmetry, odd symmetry, even symmetry, odd symmetry. For odd symmetry, x of minus n should be equals to, yeah, what should be this?
Minus x of n, sir.
Yes, that's fine. Minus x of n, right? For all n. See, for odd symmetry, suppose I have, okay, you have given with something. Yeah, let me have notations of this. E means even, O means odd. Like this, you can think, there's no issue with this. Here's a notation. Suppose some signal x of n is given to you. I split into two parts like this. Is it possible or not? Is it possible? I want to divide the given sequence x of n into two parts. One is even part and the other one is odd part. Linear combination of them. Is it possible?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, what should be my x of n?
X of n? Plus x of,
let me consider x of n is real sequence, is real sequence, real sequence, real x of n equals to x of n plus x of minus n divided by 2 and x naught of n, odd part of x of n equals to x of n minus x of minus n by 2. If you want, you can substitute this into this expression. Just add this one, try to add this term and this term. We are going to get the second part will be cancelled out, right? X of minus n part will be cancelled out. And we're left with 2 into x of n by 2. Then nothing but x of n. Let me check whether this is even signal or not. Even symmetric or not. If I try to substitute minus n both sides, what I am going to get is replace n with minus n, n with minus n. N with minus n means minus of minus means plus. That is nothing but your past signal only, right? It means which is equals to x e of n. So even symmetric, they know issue with this one. Let me try for this. X e of x naught of minus n equals to x of minus n. Minus of minus means plus, which is nothing but minus x naught of n. It's nothing but minus x naught of n. It's the odd part, right? I can try to split this into two parts. Any given sequence x of n into even part and odd part, two components, right? This I can do. There is no issue with this one. For example, if x of n is complex. Complex sequence, then we'll try to have something like conjugate symmetric and conjugate anti-symmetric. Something different. Conjugate symmetric means, suppose x of n is a complex sequence, then for conjugate symmetric, I need to satisfy this condition. X star of minus n should be equals to x of n. Then I can say this is a conjugate symmetric. We have extra this sign, right? For even part. Let me denote by E. Even means conjugate symmetric. E means conjugate symmetric. Like that you can think. Is similar to your even. If I remove this complex conjugate, this part, same as your even signal, right? And conjugate anti-symmetric. Conjugate anti-symmetric means, yeah, can someone speak out? What should be this? It's not a. This is some imitation of odd signal, but conjugate, with conjugate. It should be equals to minus x naught of n. Then you can call it as conjugate anti-symmetric. Suppose someone gave me some complex sequence x of n. I can try to split this into two parts. Conjugate symmetric part and conjugate anti-symmetric part as follows. Where x of n equals to x of n plus x star of minus n divided by 2 and x naught of n equals to x of n minus x star of minus n divided by 2. These two gets cancelled out. I am going to end up with x of n only. If you want, you can cross check this one. Try to do this operation. Do conjugate, replace n with minus n, and we are going to satisfy these conditions without any issue. The conjugate symmetric part is the conjugate anti-symmetric part of your complex sequence x of n. Okay, now we got some similarity with notations. Let us go to symmetric properties of DTFT, or you can say Fourier transform. By default, assume DTFT if I say Fourier transform. In order to solve those properties, first we'll simply write DTFT and inverse DTFT. DTFT equals to sigma n equals to minus infinity to plus infinity x of n e power minus j omega n, and inverse DTFT is 1 by 2 pi. This is over one period, right? One period means 2 pi. It's a periodic, right? X of e power j omega with period 2 pi. X of e power j omega is a period, 1 by 2 pi. This is also period, right? Minus pi to pi. And I want to prove this property. For a given sequence x of n, if I do complex conjugate of that sequence, this is the constant DTFT I am going to get. X star of e power minus j omega. see my claim. X star of e power minus j omega. This is my claim. I already know that x of n dt ft is x of e power j omega. Now I want to prove this. In order to prove this one, you can consider any of these two things. There is no issue. You can solve with this, or you can solve with this also. The proof of this one. Let me consider, yeah, just for basic level, I can go with this. Let me try to do this. Do complex conjugate both sides. Whole complex conjugate means AB whole star equals to A star into B star. This is complex conjugate. X plus JY whole star equals to X minus JY. Or R e power J theta whole star equals to R e power minus J theta, where R is positive real. Like that you can think. Just for your understanding purpose. Now, if I take this whole complex conjugate inside, I am going to get star here. And e power minus j omega n whole star. What is that? Complex conjugate for this term. What is that?
E power plus j omega n.
Plus, right? Plus j omega n. Now, if I do minus both sides, replacing omega with minus omega. Replace omega with minus omega both sides. Then, this minus will come out and I am going to end up with this. Which is nothing but just look into this right side part. This is nothing but DTFT for this right. If I have something like this, e power minus j omega and some sequence here, then this is nothing but DTFT for this part. DTFT for this part, right? This sequence. Here DTFT for x star of n. It means this is true, right? X star of n, DTFT for this one is x star of e power minus j omega. If you want, you can try with this also. There is no issue at all. For example, I can take complex conjugate both sides. Then this will become star. Then this will become minus complex conjugate if I do that. After that, you can try to replace. You can go for variable transformation. I'll try to have omega dash equals to minus omega and implies d omega dash equals to minus d omega. This will become minus, right? Minus d omega dash. And after that, earlier this is omega equals to minus pi to pi. Now omega dash equals to plus pi to minus pi. Minus integral a to b is nothing but integral b to a. These two are equal. I can interchange once again and I'll get back to my minus pi to pi. In that way also you can solve. Anything is fine. You can use this or this in order to derive those properties. Yeah, in my view, it's better not to by heart the properties. Try to derive the properties with the help of these basic expressions. It looks good for you. Instead of remembering too many things, you can try to apply very, very small tricks. Basic tricks you can apply. It might be good for you if you do it in that way. Even the derivation looks very easy, right? You can do it in 5 seconds. Once you got familiarity with those derivations. And x star of minus n implies x star of e power j omega. I already know that x of n, x of e power j omega, and the claim here is x star of minus n, x complex conjugate. X star of e power j omega, right? Otherwise, let me recall that this also fine, right? X star of n implies this we already proved. E power minus j omega. Now we want to prove this one. If I replace n with minus n, some change is there, right? That's what we need to prove. just for my basic understanding, I can do this, right? Okay, let me try with this. If I do complex conjugate both sides, x star of n, whole star, right? This will become like complex conjugate, and this will become like minus j omega n d omega. Like this, I am going to get. After that, I am replacing n with minus n. Replace n with minus n both sides. Minus n means minus of minus means plus. Now what is this? Yeah, forget about this part. How this looks like? Inverse dt of t for. See, if I have something like this, 1 by 2 pi integral minus pi to pi something into e power j omega and d omega, then that part corresponds to dt of t for this left side part, right? It means I can say that x star of e power j omega a dt of t for x star of minus n. Like that I can do, right? It's fairly straightforward. And one more thing, real part of x of n, if I can start only real part of x of n, then I am going to get conjugate symmetric part of x of e power j omega. Yeah, can someone prove this? Till now what we know is x of n dt of t is x of e power j omega, and x star of minus n dt of t is x of e power, yeah, what is this for the dt of t for this? This is x star of e power j omega, right? This thing we know, and in addition to this, we already know this. X star of e power minus j omega. Up to this we know, right? Up to this we know. Now, real part of x of n. Yeah, how to find the real part of x of n? How to find? Suppose x plus jy is given to you. How to find real part of this one? Plus x plus j y whole star divided by 2. Is it okay? What is this value then? Yeah, can someone answer what is this?
X.
X, right? Because this is x minus j y. And if I want to know imaginary part of this one, I can simply go for difference, right? X plus j y minus x plus j y complex conjugate divided by 2. Then I am going to get j into y. This is j into y. J into imaginary part. Like that I can get, right? Similarly, if I want to know real part of this one, I can simply go for this. Let me erase this part. X of n, where x of n is a complex sequence, x star of minus, yeah, x of n plus x star of n divided by 2, right, for real part of this. Now what is the dt of t for this? I already know dt of t for x of n, and I know dt of t for x star of n also, right? Yes, then what is this? I can apply dt of t for this whole thing. I know dt of t for x of n is x of e power j omega, and dt of t for this part is x star of e power minus j omega now divided by 2. This is nothing but conjugate symmetric part, right? Conjugate symmetric part of x of e power j omega, this one. Similarly, you can try to prove that for odd part, we are going to get conjugate anti-symmetric part, right? This will become minus for odd part, and this will become minus. Then we are going to get conjugate odd symmetric part of x of e power j omega. That's what we can see here. And whenever x of n is a real, these are the properties that are going to hold when x of n is real. Yeah, here itself we can answer, right? When x of n is real, what will be this? X star of minus n equals to x of minus n, right? Because see, when x is a real, x star equals to x. That's what we are doing here, right? And this also equals to x, x of n, x star of n equals to x of n, when that is a real. For real x of n, you can replace complex conjugate of that sequence with x of n itself, right? X of minus n. In that way, we can proceed, right? And if you try this one, x of e by j omega. Okay, is it true or false? I think we already saw this somewhere in our last week's session, right? For real signal x of n, this is satisfied. This will be satisfied. Conjugate symmetric property. Yeah, we already saw this. And here also we can try this. This is just a basic extension to what we discussed now. If x of n is a real sequence, then the DTFT will be conjugate symmetric. It means x of e power j omega equals x star of e power minus j omega. Or you can simply say that x of e power minus j omega equals to x star of e power j omega. If I apply complex conjugate both sides, then x star of e power j omega equals to x of e power j omega minus j omega. That's also fine. And real part is even symmetric. Imaginary part will be odd symmetric. This is for x of n real. And magnitude is even symmetric and phase is odd symmetric. Phase is odd symmetric. And again, have a look into this one. This is straightforward from this last two. Let's try to understand this with the help of an example. Let's consider an example. X of n equals to a power n u of n. It means that x of n equals to a power n for all n greater than or equals to 0. Otherwise, that is equal to 0. Where a is real and mod a less than 1. Let's consider this example case. And if I apply DTFT for that one, I'm going to end up with this expression. If I do sigma x of n, e power minus j omega n, then I am going to get this one. 1 by 1 minus a, e power minus j omega, where mod a less than 1. If mod a not less than 1, that may diverge, that won't converge. Let us try to analyze this one. Where a is a real, it means our x of n is a real sequence here. If that is a real sequence, means, yeah, what are the properties of DTFT when there is a real sequence? Magnitude should be even symmetric, phase should be odd symmetric, and there should be conjugate symmetric, right? Conjugate symmetric. The DTFT should be conjugate symmetric. That's what we have seen. Let us cross check that only. One by one minus a e power minus j omega. If I do complex conjugate both sides, then I am going to get one by, yeah, what is this? Yeah, can you speak out? I am doing complex conjugate both sides of this expression. Is it plus or minus?
Plus.
C plus j omega, right? And if I do this, x star of e power minus j omega, replacing omega with minus omega, both sides of this expression. 1 minus a e power minus j omega. replacing omega with minus omega, right? This is nothing but x of e power j omega. It means that is conjugate symmetric, right? Our sequence x of n is a real sequence, a power n u of n, where a is real. And finally, we are going to end up with this only, right? It's a conjugate symmetric that got proved. When x of n is real, yeah. I want to find a real part and imaginary part of this expression. This is the way I am going to follow. I want to divide this into two parts like this. Real part of this one, h r of e power j omega plus j into imaginary part of x r of e power j omega. I want to do like this. I want to know what is my real part and what is my imaginary part. For that, I am expanding this. This will become a cos omega minus j sin omega, right? Now, if I try to have like this, okay. Let me go to basic example. If I have something like this, what is the real part and what is the imaginary part for this? How to find real part and imaginary part for this? See, what I can do is, just for my simplification purpose, I can multiply and divide with complex conjugate. X minus jy divided by x minus jy. Then I am going to end up with x minus jy divided by, yeah, what is the multiplication of these two? X plus jy into x minus jy. X square plus y square, right? See, a plus b into a minus b equals to a square minus b square. Here b equals to jy. J square equals to minus 1, right? That way I am going to end up with x square plus y square. And what is the real part and imaginary part for this? What is the real part of this?
X by x square plus y square, sir.
Yeah. This is real part and this is imaginary part. Imaginary part corresponds to minus jy divided by x square plus y square, or minus y by x square plus y square corresponds to imaginary part. Minus y divided by x square plus y square. That's imaginary part. In that way, we need to proceed. I want to do in a similar manner for this also. A corresponds to, here x corresponds to real part of this, right? 1 plus a cos omega, and y corresponds to jy, right? X plus jy minus a sin omega, x and y. Now you can apply the same trick here also. And finally, we are going to end up with real part and imaginary part as follows. And according to our theory, when x of n is a real sequence, real part should be even symmetric and imaginary part should be odd symmetric. You can have a look into this one. This is my x r of e power j omega. If I replace omega with minus omega here, I will get with same expression. Replace omega with minus omega here and here. Then cos of minus omega is cos omega, right? See, cos of minus theta is cos theta. If I replace omega with minus omega, I am going to end up with same expression. It's even symmetric. And let's go to imaginary part. If I replace omega with minus omega, what is sine of minus theta? Sine of minus theta. Is it sine theta or minus sine theta?
Minus sine theta.
Minus sine theta, right? Then we are going to end up with plus a sine omega and cos of minus omega is cos omega. This remains same denominator. Then we are going to get opposite sign for that, right? It's odd symmetric. Binary part is odd symmetric. And let's go for magnitude. See, in order to find the magnitude, it's better not to use this expression. If I do in this way, that will be a bit lengthy in order to get this expression finally. Straight away, I am applying magnitude to this term. Mod x of e power j omega. If we want to do here, you should write like root xr of e power j omega whole square plus xi of e power j omega whole square. Because real part is imaginary part, right? That is a bit lengthy. In order to avoid that one, I am applying straight away here. Mod of this one equals to mod of this equals to mod of this. And finally, what I applied is 1 by mod x plus jy. Yeah, what is this? I want to see magnitude of this one. 1 by root x square plus y square, right? That's what we are doing here. See the real part, this imaginary part, real part square plus imaginary part square. 1 divided by square root of 1 minus a cos omega whole square plus a sin omega whole square. And cos square omega plus sin square omega equals to 1, right? If I do that simplification, I'm going to end up with this expression. It's a magnitude spectrum, which is even symmetric. If you want, you can verify. Replace omega with minus omega. Cos of minus omega is cos omega. I'm going to end up with same expression. It's a magnitude spectrum is even symmetric. And there's a phase I'm going to get. Phase means, yeah, can someone answer what is the phase of this? What is the phase for this one?
Tan inverse of y by x, sir.
Tan inverse of y by x. Or minus tan inverse.
If it is in the numerator, it is minus, sir.
No. See, x plus jy, I can write like this. R e power j theta, right? Where r equals to root x square plus y square. And theta equals to tan inverse y by x. Theta equals to tan inverse y by x. Like this, I can write. This is nothing but 1 by r into e power minus j theta. It means this part corresponds to minus theta corresponds to my phase, right? Minus tan inverse y by x. This is my phase. Suppose if this is minus sign, 1 by x minus jy, then this will be plus, right? If this is minus. Yeah, we can do in the similar lines. This is my x, this is my y, and you can do this, right? And minus tan inverse of theta equals to tan inverse of minus theta. I took that minus inside of this one. That's what we had done here. The minus came inside. Now this should be odd symmetric, right? Replace omega with minus omega. Sine of minus omega is minus sine omega. This will become plus. And cos of minus omega is cos. Denominator remains same. Numerator, we have opposite sign for this, right? This is odd symmetric. And you can have these example figures later. And you can try to observe that even symmetry and odd symmetry. These are some of the Fourier transform theorems, some important theorems. Linearity property. Linearity property means, suppose I have dt f t for x of n is x of e power j omega, and dt f t for y of n is y of e power j omega, then the dt f t for this linear combination will be a into x of e power j omega plus b into y of e power j omega. It's a linearity property of dt of t. And x of n minus nd leads to this one. Can someone prove this? I'll give you the hint. You can start with this expression. 1 by 2 pi, this is a synthesis equation, right? Minus pi 2 pi x of e power j omega into e power j omega n d omega. Now I want to see what is the dt of t for x of n minus nd, delayed version of this sequence x of n. Replace n with n minus nd both sides. Replace n with n minus nd both sides. Then I am going to have integral minus pi to pi x of e power j omega into, this will become like e power j into omega into n minus nd. Can I split this into two parts? E power a plus b equals to e power a into e power b, right? I can do in this way. J omega n d into e power j omega n d omega. And if you look into this right side term, it is just dt of t, inverse dt of t for this term. The coefficient of e power j omega n, right? This is the coefficient of e power j omega n. This is the dt of t for this one. X of n minus nd implies x of e power j omega into e power minus j omega nd. It's a phase shift, right? Linear phase. Omega nd minus omega nd. It's a linear phase. If you apply a delay by nd samples, then you are going to get some phase shift. That's it. The gain of the components is unchanged, right? Because magnitude of this one is always 1. Mod e power minus j omega nd. That gain is unaffected. Only phase shift is there. Minus omega nd is the phase shift for the frequency omega. Similarly, e power j omega naught n into x of n implies x of e power j into omega minus omega naught. You can apply here itself. If you try to multiply both sides with e power j omega naught n, multiply both sides with e power j omega naught n, can I take this e power j omega naught inside this summation integration? Here the variable is omega and this is constant. When this is a constant, I can take this inside this summation, right? Inside this integration or continuous summation. Then this will become like e power j omega naught n multiplication. And if you simplify this, this will be e power j into omega plus omega naught into n. And let me call this as some omega dash. Omega plus omega naught equals omega dash. And you can try to do manipulations, the variable transformation. Then we are going to end up with this one. Something similar to your modulation property in signal transition course, right? Then we are going to end up with x of e power j into omega minus omega naught. And this is a folding. X of minus n leads to x of e power minus j omega. If x of n is a real, we already know that these two are equal. If x of n is real, this can be written like this. N into x of n leads to j into dx of e power j omega by d omega. Let us have a look into this. N into x of n, right? X of e power j omega equals to sigma n equals minus infinity plus infinity. You can use any one of them. Analysis or synthesis equation in order to solve them. If I do differentiation with respect to omega both sides, d by d omega of this one, what is derivative of this one with respect to omega? Yeah, what is derivative with respect to omega? I can take this inside this one because these two are linear operations. I can take this inside this summation. Sigma n x of n, derivative for e power minus j omega n with respect to omega. J omega n into minus j n, right? See, what is derivative for e power ax? What is derivative?
A into e power ax.
Yes, e power ax into derivative of this part, right? It means e power ax into a. Similarly, we are doing the same thing. This one into derivative of this part with respect to omega, that is minus jn, right? Now, if I multiply both sides with j, just try to multiply both sides with j. Is j square equals to minus 1, minus of minus is plus. This gets cancelled out. Now I can try to have my expression like this, sigma n x of n e power minus j omega n. This corresponds to ddft for n x of n, right? Is nothing but j into d by d omega of x of e power j omega. Now this you can have. Similarly, this will extend further. I can go for second derivative and keeps on doing something like that. The convolution property. X of n convolution, linear convolution with y of n implies multiplication in the DDFT domain, the frequency domain. The linear convolution, x of n convolution with y of n implies x of e power j omega into y of e power j omega. This is multiplication in time domain. Is a periodic convolution in frequency domain, periodic convolution. Because in DDFT, they are periodic with period 2 pi, right? The spectrum is periodic with period 2 pi. That's why this is a periodic convolution. It's a periodic convolution expression. It's a Parsworth theorem. It's energy, right? Energy of the sequence x of n equals to 1 by 2 pi integral minus pi to pi mod x of e power j omega whole square d omega. We are trying to look into the strength contributed by each of the frequency components. After that, we are taking average, right? Average over all the frequencies, 1 by 2 pi, that interval, right? These two are equal. Energy of the signal is same as this one. And similarly, you can have a look into this one, this expression. Okay, let us go through some DDFT pairs, whatever we have done in love. If x of n equals to delta of n, this will be x of e power j omega. X of e power j omega equals to 1. If x of n equals to delta of n minus n naught, then x of e power j omega is nothing but e power minus j omega n naught. E power minus j omega n naught. If you have doubt, you can simply apply DDFT for this. Sigma n equals to minus infinity plus infinity, delta of n minus n naught into e power minus j omega n. Except at n equal to n naught, this is always equal to 0. At n equal to n naught, you have multiplication with e power minus j omega n naught, right? That will come out. And DDFT for constant is something like DC, right? X of n equals to 1 for all n. This we already saw. With the help of special functions, you can do this, right? And a power n u of n for modulus n 1, 1 by 1 minus a e power minus j omega. This is a DDFT. Is the standard functions that you need to remember if possible. Otherwise, you can derive. There is no issue with this one. And u of n, unit step sequence, which is equals to 1 for all n greater than or equal to 0. Otherwise, this is equal to 0. The DDFT we already derived, right? We are having half DC. DC value for this one is 1 by 2. And for that, we found DDFT. This is the DDFT we got. And for the remaining part is the DDFT. With the help of some recursive expression, we had done that, right? And n plus 1 into a power n u of n. This is a DTFT for that. Okay, how to solve this? Is there any hint? Can you give me the hint? I know DTFT for a power n u of n. This is my DTFT. How to find DTFT for n into a power n u of n? Can someone answer me this? I know DTFT for a power n u of n, where mod a less than 1. I know DTFT for this one is 1 by 1 minus a into e power minus j omega. This thing I already know. Can someone tell me what is the DTFT for n into a power n u of n? Just now we have seen some property, right?
Differentiation.
Yes, it's good. Differentiation, right? There should be j into differentiation of this one with respect to omega. D by d omega of this thing. Now you can simplify this. And the differentiation you can do, right? You can apply u by v rule, the differentiation. And if you try to simplify that one, we are going to end up with this. You can make use of that property. N into a power n u of n. See, this can be split into two parts, right? N into a power n u of n plus a power n u of n. You know DTFT for a power n u of n, and you know DTFT for n into a power n u of n. You can add them together. Then we are going to end up with this one. And this is one thing you need to remember. If possible, you can remember. Otherwise, no need. How to solve this? Is there any hint? How to solve this? This is some constant. Sin omega p is a constant. You can split this into two parts, right? Sin theta equals to e power j theta plus e power minus j theta by 2, where theta equals to omega p into n plus 1. After that, you can merge r power n and that e power j something into n. And you can simplify, right? Something like this only. We are going to get something similar to this one only. Two terms you are going to get. And if you simplify this, we are going to end up with this. Yeah, I can try to solve this. You can make use of this one to solve this one. You can just simplify this into two parts. E power j theta minus e power minus j theta divided by 2j. This one. Sin theta equals, where theta equals omega p into n plus 1. And this we already saw, right? It's an ideal low pass filter impulse response. N omega c n by pi n. It's an ideal low pass filter with the cutoff frequency omega c. And x of n equals to 1 is a moving average system. We already saw this derivation. And e power j omega naught also we saw, right? If you know DTFT for 1, it's simply modulation property, right? If you want, you can apply this. There's no issue with this. If you know DTFT for 1 into e power j omega naught n, x of e power j into omega minus omega naught, right? You can do that. There's no issue with this. Replace omega with omega minus omega naught here. These two are same, right? Yeah. And how to solve this? Cos omega naught n plus pi DTFT. Once again, same trick you can apply. Cos theta equals to e power j theta plus e power minus j theta divided by 2. And you can apply DTFT for them and simplify. It's something similar to this, where a can be complex and mod a should be less than 1. Let us have some example problems on Fourier transform properties. X of n equals to a power n into u of n minus 5. Mod a less than 1. Yeah, can someone answer this? I know this DTFT. 1 by 1 minus a e power minus j omega. Mod a less than 1. And I already know something also, some property also. Let me call it as x of n. Then what is x of n minus 5? Replace n with n minus 5, right? N minus 5 into u of n minus 5. And what is the dt of t for x of n minus 5? X of n dt of t is x of e power j omega. Let us have a look into properties. N minus n naught. What is the dt of t for this? E power minus j omega n naught into x of e power j omega. The property I am going to apply. X of n minus 5 means I am going to end up with this, right? E power minus j omega into 5. 5 omega into x of e power j omega means this one. 1 by 1 minus a e power minus j omega. But my given expression is this. A power n into u of n minus 5. A power n into u of n minus 5. Then how to find the dt of t for this? I know dt of t for this one is this. I want to know the dt of t for a power n u of n minus 5. How to proceed? I can multiply both sides with a power 5. Then this gets cancelled out, right? This 5 gets cancelled out. Then this is my final dt of t I am expecting. This is my final dt of t. A power 5 into e power minus j 5 omega divided by 1 minus a e power minus j omega, where mod a less than 1. This is a dt of t I am going to get finally. Yeah, that's what we had done here. Yeah, can someone answer this? Okay, let me look into partial fraction expansion once. 1 by x minus a into x minus b. This is a partial fraction expansion I am going to do now. X minus b. Like this I can write. Yeah, what is this coefficient? How to find this? How to find this coefficient? You just remove this one, right? You just remove this. And after that, substitute x minus a equal to 0. After removing this term in this entire fraction, in this entire expression, remove this term, this x minus a term, and substitute that term equal to 0. X minus a equal to 0 implies x equal to a. Substitute x equal to a into this expression, leftover expression. Where you replace x with a, then I am going to get 1 by a minus b, right? 1 by a minus b. Then what will be this? Yeah, what will be this?
1 by b minus a.
Yes, 1 by b minus a, right? You can do in a similar manner. Remove this term and equate this to 0. X equal to b we are going to get. And replace x equal to b in the remaining term. 1 by b minus a. If you have doubt, you can simplify this. If you try to simplify this, we are going to end up with this expression only. The same thing we are going to do now. It's given like 1 by 1 minus a e power minus j omega into 1 minus b e power minus j omega. I can try to split this into two parts. Partial fraction expansion e power minus j omega plus 1 minus b e power minus j omega in the denominator. I want to find what is my numerator. In order to find this, how to proceed? You can apply same trick. You can equate this one to 0. This term you can equate to 0. 1 minus a e power minus j omega equal to 0 implies e power minus j omega equals to e power minus j omega equals to 1 by a, right? E power minus j omega equals to 1 by a. Replace 1 by a in place of e power j omega, e power minus j omega in the remaining term, leftover term, right? Replace this one with 1 by a. Then we are going to end up with a by a minus b, right? A by a minus b. Because 1 divided by 1 minus b by a. If you simplify that, a by a minus b. Then what is this? You can apply same trick. Equate this one to 0. Equate this one to 0. Then e power minus j omega equals to 1 by b. Replace 1 by b equal to e power minus j omega here in this term. Replace this one with 1 by b. Then we are going to end up with b by b minus a. It's a partial fraction expansion for that. Now, can someone answer what is the inverse DTFT for this? And it is already given that mod a less than b, mod b less than, mod a less than 1, mod b less than 1. Yeah, what is the inverse DTFT for this? A by a minus b into what is the DTFT for inverse DTFT for 1 by 1 minus a e power minus j omega?
A power n into?
Yes, a power n into u of n, right? It's good. That's fine. Similarly, this is a constant b by b minus a into inverse DTFT for 1 by 1 minus b e power minus j omega when mod b less than 1. This should be maintained. Otherwise, you'll be in trouble, right? That may not converge if you want to satisfy this one. This will be b power n into u of n. Okay, that is fine. Can someone tell me what is the convolution of a power n u of n with b power n u of n? It's a linear convolution. Is it easy or difficult? I am asking you to compute this graphically. The linear convolution of these two things. I said that is very, very difficult. It's not so easy. It is a bit difficult and lengthy. But I can try this one. I can apply convolution property, right? The DTFT for this one is multiplication in the frequency domain. X of e power j omega into y of e power j omega. Now, if I apply inverse DTFT for this, I am going to get convolution of x of n and y of n, right? The same thing we are doing here. This part corresponds to DTFT of a power n u of n. This part corresponds to DTFT of b power n into u of n, where mod a less than 1, mod b less than 1. We are multiplying that in frequency domain. And if I apply inverse DTFT for this, inverse DTFT for that, we are going to end up with convolution of a power n u of n and b power n u of n. This is nothing but convolution of a power n u of n and b power n u of n. It will simplify our life so easily, right? That's the benefit we are going to get if you go further. Properties, Fourier transform properties. Indirectly, we computed linear convolution of the two sequences, a power n u of n and b power n u of n. If you want to find that indirectly, first apply DTFT for those two sequences. You can multiply those two. After that, you can apply inverse DTFT for that multiplied signal, that multiplied DTFT. Then we are going to end up with convolution of those signals, right? Is some shortcut for you. Finding convolution directly may not be easy sometimes. In that case, you can apply DTFT first. After that, multiply them. After multiplication, you can apply IDTFT, inverse DTFT for that. And the result we are going to get is linear convolution of those two sequences. The same trick you can apply for your LTA systems, right? Y of e power j omega equals to x of e power j omega into h of e power j omega. If you apply inverse DTFT, you are going to get convolution of x of n and h of n. Okay, ideal high pass filter. This is ideal high pass filter with some phase shift. That's it. In your pass band. And I want to implement this with the help of low pass system. Yeah, this is what I am planning. Okay, let me try to simplify this problem further. This is my ideal digital low pass filter. Ideal digital low pass filter. H low pass of omega. Okay. E power j omega. I want to mention periodicity with period 2 pi, right? Yeah. We have this one. Can someone, yeah, can you recollect what is H of n? For ideal low pass filter. With cutoff frequency omega c. Sin omega c n by pi n, right? This we already saw earlier. Sin omega c n by pi n. I already know impulse response of ideal low pass filter. As mentioned here. Now, if I ask a question like, what is the impulse response for ideal high pass filter with a cutoff frequency omega c. High pass filter means high frequency component is nearby pi, right? Highest possible frequency component is a high pass filter, digital high pass filter. Yeah, can someone answer how to get this from this? Oh, if I want to, yeah, I'll already give you a hint to you. By default, that is periodic period 2 pi, right? Omega c, this is 0. This is low pass, ideal low pass. Pi and minus pi. And this will repeat for every 2 pi. 0 will be shifted to 2 pi, right? And this will become like 2 pi minus omega c, 2 pi plus omega c, and this will go to 4 pi once again, and this will repeat. Similarly, minus 2 pi, this will repeat, minus 4 pi, that will repeat, and so on. This by default you can have. When coming to high pass filter, this will repeat for every 2 pi, 0 shifted to 2 pi. Let me have 2 pi somewhere here. 2 pi. And minus pi shifted to what point? Yeah, you can speak out. Minus pi shifted to what point?
Pi.
Pi, right? Minus pi plus 2 pi means pi at this point. And minus omega c plus 2 pi. Minus omega c plus 2 pi means somewhere here. Like that you might expect, right? It means we are going to end up like this. Yeah, in that way we are going to get. Similarly, nearby minus 3 pi, we are going to get something like this. This box will repeat. Like that we are going to get. I want to get this one with the help of this. How to proceed? You can apply some properties. Is it okay if I do like this? I'll consider all pass filter first. All pass filter means H all pass of omega, e power j omega, c omega. See minus pi to pi, this is always equals to 1. This is all pass filter. And this is repeating for every 2 pi, right? By default, this is extend. There's no issue with that. And if you want some clarity, just remove this minus pi 2 pi Gangster. And low pass filter. Low pass filter is minus omega c to omega c. This is minus pi, this is pi. And if I subtract this one from this, this minus this, h low pass of e power j omega, I am subtracting this one from the h all pass. Then I am going to get h high pass of e power j omega. Because 1 minus 1 is 0, 1 minus 0 is 1, right? Between omega c to pi, that will become 1. Between minus pi to minus omega c, that will become 1. And between minus omega c to omega c, that will become 0. If you do point by point subtraction, that's what we are going to get, right? I can get ideal high pass filter with the help of ideal low pass filter by applying this trick, right? High pass of e power j omega equals to ideal 1 minus h low pass of e power j omega. Like this I can do. Implies h high pass of n. Impulse response of ideal high pass filter. What is the inverse DTFT for 1? This is delta fn, right? If you apply DTFT for delta fn, you are going to get 1. And I know low pass filter impulse response, right? Sin omega cn by pi n. In that way, I can find. This is my ideal high pass filter impulse response. Or you can apply some trick also. There is some one more trick. You can try this. Consider low pass filter with a cutoff frequency of pi minus omega c. And this side that will become like, this is pi minus omega c. What is this? Minus pi plus omega c, right? And this is minus, okay, plus pi. And this is minus pi. Low pass filter with the cutoff frequency is this. And if I do this, e power j omega, okay, control, yeah, e power j pi n into x low pass of n. Yeah, what is the DTFT for this? What is the DTFT for this? Let me go for h, right? Notation, impulse response notation. Based on the properties, you can do this. Let me consider this like omega naught n. E power j omega naught n into x of n implies x of e power j into omega minus omega naught. J into omega minus omega naught means pi. Like this will happen. Now 0 will be shifted to pi. Shifting right side by pi, right? And this is periodic period to pi. 0 shifted to pi means it is becoming like high pass filter, right? We are going to end up with this. And what happens to minus pi plus omega c? Shifted to what? Omega c plus pi. Shifted right side by pi, right? Pi gets cancelled out. This got shifted to omega c. Then that is exactly same as your ideal high pass filter. If you want, you can apply this trick also. Where e power j pi n equals to? What is e power j pi? Yeah, what is e power j pi means? Cos pi plus j sin pi. What is that? Minus 1 whole power n, right? It means you can have minus 1 whole power n into h low pass of n. Also corresponds to high pass filter, right? It means finally I can end up with this also. H high pass of n equals to minus 1 whole power n into h low pass of n, but with cutoff frequency pi minus omega c. In place of omega c, I will have pi minus omega c. Sin of pi into omega c into n divided by pi n. This is ideal high pass filter with the cutoff frequency of omega c. This is one way and this is another way. You can apply any of these two tricks. Here I applied a linearity property. H Here I applied that modulation property or something is there, right? This modulation property. Anything is okay. And you can have a look into this one. Slight modification to what we had done till now. That's multiplication with the phase. And impulse response of difference equation. The difference equation we are having. Now we can try to apply yeah, what is the DTFT for this? DTFT for this one is y of e power j omega. What is the DTFT for y of n minus 1? Inverse of y of e power j omega.
E power minus j omega, y of...
Yes. E power minus j omega and y of e power j omega, right? Similarly, I can do here also. And impulse response is nothing but inverse DTFT for h of e power j omega, right? Where h of e power j omega equals to y of e power j omega divided by x of e power j omega. I can simplify in that way. Yes. I can simplify in that way. Otherwise, you can apply in that trick. Replace x of n with delta of n because you want to find impulse response, right? Once you replace it with the delta of n, the output y of n we are going to get is h of n, impulse response, right? Y of n is h of n. Y of n minus 1 is h of n minus 1. Replacing x with delta means this will happen. Now we can apply DTFT both sides. It's a property, right? DTFT properties. From here, we can get h of e power j omega. And you can do partial fraction expansion followed by inverse DTFT. Then we are going to end up with this expression. This is the impulse response of that LTA system. In this way, you can find. Otherwise, you can straight away find here itself, where h of e power j omega equals to y of e power j omega divided by x of e power j omega. In that way also, you can find. You can try in that way. Both will be same. Yeah, thank you.